everyone, welcome back to BTM Scum Modeling for week 6 on the USS Saratoga, which is a 1/537th scale AMT Miranda class starship, and week 3 on the shuttle Discovery, which is the Rebel 1/144th. It's been a pretty good week. Had to do some balancing, so I balanced working on the bases and then getting stuff done on the kits, and then doing things that I needed to get done outside since it's finally starting to warm up. So trying to balance everything out, and one thing after another. But what I will say, and I'm not going to take away from the video, is I did get lights turned on, and that's where I'm going to leave that. And with the Discovery, I've gotten pretty much the sanding and stuff out of the way, and hopefully I set for the booster rockets and the fuel tank, but starting to get stuff done on the shuttle. So with that, guys, if you are new to my channel, please click on the subscribe button and then click on the little bell, and every time I upload, you'll be notified. And always thank you to all my subscribers. I really, really do appreciate it. Also, please, if you have a question, a comment, way to go, or what the heck were you thinking, Buck, please put it in the comment section. I usually respond within 12 to 24 hours. But with that, guys, let's go to the bench and see what did get done this week. Well, good Tuesday, everyone. Getting back to work on the bench inside the studio. Like I said, I got working on the bases last week, and I spent yesterday doing some tweaks and getting some things squared away, and they're outside with the getting dry from the nail putty so I could hide those. Getting both, got the base for the Discovery getting ready to go and the base for the Saratoga. But what I want to show you guys is, so as you saw, I did all that putty and studded, and then when I sanded it, I could definitely tell I still had a seam. So what I did was I went and actually got, let me see if I can find it. What I got was 400 grit sandpaper. I had the 320, but I wanted something that was like 800, but actually got better, so did take care of all those. So that's where we're at, and I'm going to work on getting more lighting into the Saratoga, getting it ready to go, and when I start doing that, I will be back to share. But right now, I'm going to look and see what else I need to do to start getting parts that I can deal with, and so I'm not messing with the decals when I go ready to do that. But so that's where I'm at right now, guys. So I shall return when I have more to show. Well, good morning. It's Wednesday and getting back to work. As you guys can tell, I'm getting the lighting done. So most of the lower part of the ship is done. I still have to do my overall interior lighting, but I got all these little guys done up, and yeah. And I was trying to figure out, was I going to put the computer board on bottom or on top? Well, the one thing I did figure out is I probably could, but I'm not going to. I had the computer board glued here, and then I tried to test fit the ship. Most of it fit together, but because of the wiring, it just, because of the hardnesses in on the computer board, it was a little hard. So yeah, so I can get the ship to fit nice and tight together, I will be wiring in the base, running everything into the base. So there's that. So I'm gonna get back to work, and I will show you guys when I got more done. See you in a little bit. Good afternoon, still Wednesday, and yes, the lighting is now, everything's wired up. I still got a little bit of cleanup to do, but really liking the impulse crystal, and then yeah, still got a little bit of cleanup to do and get some things working, but really, really liking that. That's worked out really well. And then yes, I do have the navigation, or not the registry one, and then turnover. So yes, very happy. So now it's gonna take a break and start getting things cleaned up. I'm not putting this together yet because I still got to do some cleanup on some things before I can and run some other wiring, but thought I'd share that with you guys. So let's see, there you go, guys. All right, when I have more to show, I will. See you later. Good afternoon, it's Thursday, and yes, getting back to more work. It's the afternoon. I was doing getting some things fixed this morning that I needed to, and as you can tell, I'm starting the mess of not only the wires, but doing everything. So I have got the posts put in, and I used a Gorilla Epoxy. I'll have to look at it, but normally I try to epoxy those in, but I used an epoxy putty instead, and it works great. I mean, this thing is good, tight, and secure. So yes, right now, what I was doing this morning was I was starting to get things tied up, get things running out to the roll bar, and start getting things down. So I can hook it all up. But I did have to look at something else because I was test fitting yesterday, and give me just a second, sorry guys. I was test fitting the two parts of the ship, and I kept running into a problem on the bow. And the problem was, let me show you. So this is a 1.8 LED, very small, not the smallest one, but very small, and it works really good. Works really great on all the sides, but what I ran into is on the bow, it was up too much, so it was just bowing, it wasn't fitting properly. So what I had to do was not only take the LED out, but I had to go in and start, I had to grind down. I didn't grind all the way through the ship, but I ground down enough that I could get this flat better against that seam line. So, yeah. But because I spent so much time on the Saratoga yesterday and part of the morning, I'm going to clean the desk off and let's get some work done on the shuttle Discovery. I need to just take a break from this for a few hours and let everything get good and dry that I had to repaint and re-tulip slick. So let me get the desk cleaned and I'll bring over the Discovery and see what I'm going to do with that. All right, desk cleaned off. Everything's together a bit better now. And like I said, gonna get started on the Discovery. So I still got a lot of pre-building to do. But one of the things I'm going to go ahead and do is get these guys all, let me get this fixed real quick. Sorry about that, guys. There we go. Zoom out a little bit. There we go. So I'm gonna get these guys painted up and ready to go and get some parts on to here. And yeah, so right now, like I said, this is a rebel kit, so I've already got this. I primered this so I could definitely, I still got some putty work to do, like right in here on the wing and just a little bit here, and that's pretty much about it. A little more sanding there, but before I do that, I want to go ahead and get these guys on and set into place. Now I won't be able to put the thruster or the OS or the thruster jets on until I get this set. And I might, because I want to go ahead and get this so it's puttied and nice looking, but I need to get things shaved down a bit. So that's what I'm working on now, guys, is trying to get this ready. I'm going to go ahead and get these guys primed up and good to go, and I'm going to get these guys where I can get them on here and then re-etch some things and get going, because I still got to do the rest of the cargo bay and start on the boosters and that. So that's where we're at right now, or where I'm at right now. So let me get some things taken care of and I'll be back and share with you. All right, well, I've got these parts on and I've got the resin in and getting everything re-sanded down and gonna make sure it looks really good, let it get a little bit more dry. I mean, this is that plastic putty, dries really quick, but I want to make sure. But yeah, sweet, just took up more a couple of places and yay. And share this with you guys. I'll put it together first and then we'll go from there. So yes, look at that. Let me zoom out so you can get it all on camera. So solid fuel tank and the solid tank and the booster rockets. Solid rocket boosters, I don't know. I'll have to double check. But yeah, and right now, like I said, they're glued, they're getting dry, but there's a lot of little parts you're supposed to put on. So I'm going to paint those probably separate. And so I can paint this. And yeah, but right now, let that get good and dry. And then I'll start taking care of the repairs on that. So with that, I also took care of the front canopy. Since there is no interior, I just went ahead and just kind of, I used smoke to darken it up. So you're not trying to really look in there and see anything, but now I know they do interiors for it, but I'm not going to do that because I got a lot already going on with this. But yeah, so smoked up the front canopy and that. So I'm letting these things get dry, I'm going to go step outside because it's nice. It's up about 64 and get some more work done on the bases and get some fresh air. And I'll come back and share with you guys what I did with the bases. So I'll see you in a little while. Well, hope you're having a great Friday. Getting back to work, had to go do some things this morning, and thought I was actually going to have to do kind of end it from the last video I did, because it's supposed to be 80 degrees here today, but it's still about 50 with about a 30 mile hour wind. So yeah, I get to work, but I had to go run some errands. So my goal today is, one, you don't hear the exhaust fan going, but I need to get the another coat onto the shuttle. And so I can start working on getting that ready to get decaled. But one thing I do want to try to do finish is getting the spaghetti mess that is wiring together. But that's my goal, is I'm wanting to hopefully get this sealed up so it has a weekend. But we'll see where we go. But yeah. So what I got left to do is run the nacelles, the strobes, and the phaser banks and the torpedoes and the one ground wire. So the great thing is that I can run the ground from the torpedoes into the ground, and then the same for the warp nacelle, and then I got to run the strobes and get that squared away. But yeah, so that's where I'm at right now, guys. And when I get more finished, I will share with you so you guys can see. All right. Well, it is together, and it was a kind of a bear. Like I said, we all know this kid has some very bad fit issues. So as you can see right here, I had to put in a styrene rod because the gap was just crazy. So there's definitely a lot of sanding to do and a lot of that. But with that rod, it actually looks, sorry, let me keep in camera, it looks like a saucer section or a ship. So yay. And yes, yeah, so yay for that. And the shuttle is now painted in what I'm going to do the masking, or not the masking, but that big thing of decals. And I'll share that with you. But yeah, wow, what a bear. But it does have some prettiness to it, though. Let's see if I can do this again for you guys. And I've not got all of it hooked up, but I have tested it. But hey, check that out. Now let me turn that off. Check that out. That is really, really, really neat. So yay. And but yeah. So I'm going to let this get dry and see what else I can do. So I'll be back real soon. All right. Kind of wanted to show you. Like I said, I got the base stained. I really like it. It really pops with this. Oh, yep. And yeah, you can tell nothing's really set yet because I'm just wanting to show you. And get the lights on. Come around. Up. And on the bottom here, sorry guys, just show you. Let's just set it there for right now. Yeah, nothing's on, nothing's set yet for that. But I just wanted to share that with you. So give me a second, let me get it set back up. Okay, there we go. Got it back up on that clamp. So just wanted to share that with you guys. Very, very cool. And then once everything gets, that's definitely mirror. So it's gonna be really, really neat to see. And then just kind of with everything else on it, and let's go take a look. And the impulse and the crystal, and I know there's still a lot to fix, but hey, it's together now. So with that, guys, oh, and yes, sorry. And there is the whiteness on the shuttle. So yeah, not too bad, guys. So with that, I'm gonna get sign off so I can get this video put together for you guys. But with that, I want to wish you all a very, very happy and safe weekend, and have a very happy and safe week next week, because May is coming around. May is just right outside the door. So have fun and enjoy, and I'll see you guys next week on the bench.